Hello students, how are you all? Hope you all are fine. So today our topic is the work of a fabric. Kindly remove your textbook, page number 25. Now students, who are these? These are the famous poets, Kabir Das, Namdev Maharaj, Tukaram Maharaj. These are the poets. They are the same poets and philosophers who had guided us about the art of living. Accordingly, today we are going to learn about one of the poet, great Tamil saint poet, in a form of the story about how he was and how a person should be. Now, the worth of a fabric. Thiruvalar is a celebrated Tamil poet and a philosopher. The Tamil poet of the Sangam period mentioned that was the greatest scholar in the Nanda dynasty of the north, which ruled till the 4th century. His books of teachings, Thirukkural, is considered to provide a guide for human morals and betterment in life. Now the story, The Worth of a Fabric, is written by the poet himself. That means the Tamil saint poet, yes, Thiruvalar, who had lived around 2000 years ago. Thiruvalar in his story eventually explains to a young man the importance of the hard work. He also explains that the tardiness and the ignorance can prevent a person from the living in his life to the fullest, thereby rendering it useless. The story also tells us that one should be calm in all the situations. It helps you to choose the right path in all the situations. So here in this story also, an incident has been explained. So let us see what moral it has for us and for everyone. Thiruvalar was a great Tamil saint poet who lived more than 2000 years ago. Thirukkural is the book of his teachings, preachings. It is greatly loved and respected even today. Thiruvalar was a textile weaver. He wove beautiful fabrics and saris and sold them in the market. People said that he never got angry, never used bad words, never shouted at anyone. If a person is always calm, it is always beneficial for the person himself or herself. However the situation is, always be calm and never get angry. So the people used to say that he never got angry and he never ever used any harsh or bad words, or never scolded anyone, never shouted at anyone. In the same town there lived a rich young man. He wasted most of his time roaming around with his friends. They often made fun of other people. I don't believe that people say about this valuer. So he did not believe that what the people said about the valuer. Said the young man one day, I'm sure I can make him angry. Come on, let's have some fun today. So the arrogant young man, arrogant means a person having excessive pride in himself. So the arrogant young man approached, went to the Thiruvalar in the market and picked up a beautiful piece of fabric. How much does the whole fabric cost? He asked. 8 coins. The saint named the price. The young man unfolded the fabric and tore it into two. What's the price of the piece now? So we questioned him. He took the fabric, tore into two, and then he asked, what is the price of the piece now? So as Thiruvallar was a saint and he did not got angry, so he was very silent and he did not answer anything. He was very calm. And though he was by his profession a fabric weaver, but the qualities he had was of a saint. So here, as we found that the man was very arrogant and he used to always make fun of others, so he was waiting that now the same poet will get angry. But how his reaction was, let us see. Four coins. The saint answered politely. The youth was taken aback. He was astounded. He had no words to say. Why doesn't the man get angry? He thought. He then tore the half pieces into half again. And now two coins was the answer. Now it was young man who became impatient and agitated. He got angry. He got very, very angry. He got annoyed that when I am going on tearing his pieces into two and two, but then also this poet is not getting angry. He himself got angry. He tore the pieces into half again and again, saying, now, what's the price now? So when the young man, he was surprised to see that the Tamil saint poet Thiruvallar, he is not getting angry at all. He only got agitated. He only got annoyed. And then he went on tearing and again. Thiruvallar calmly went on reducing the price to half every time. At last the fabric was reduced to rags. It was now useless. It was like a piece of old cloth. At last the fabric was reduced to rags. So Thiruvallar said in a quiet tone, now this fabric has become worthless. It does not have any value. I will not name any price for these rags. The young man did not know what to say, but he was proud of his riches. So he offered to pay 8 coins to the saint for the first time. Thiruvallar smiled, but he refused to take the money. Young man, now this fabric is of no use. It has become worthless. Why? Because no one will be able to wear it now. Do you know, fabric was not made in a day. Many people have toiled. They have worked hard day and night to make it. Farmer who grew cotton in the field worked hard for months through sun and rain. He took cotton from each boll. Boll means the pad of the cotton plant, and then gave it for spinning. Then someone else carded the cotton. Carded means what? Clean the cotton and remove the seeds from it. Then he gave for spinning. Means what? Spinning is the process of making yarn, or it is to make a thread out of cotton and spun it into long uniform threads, so that from that cotton pot the threads could be made. The threads were dyed carefully so that they took on these lovely colors. My wife and I wove the threads together, putting in the beautiful design. We thought someday someone will like this fabric. and will be happy to wear it. Then all our work would have been rewarded. When you destroyed the fabric, you destroyed all the love and labor that went on into making. Money cannot bring it back. The softly spoken words touched the young man's heart. Now he was really ashamed of himself. Now really he felt that I had did something very, very wrong, which I should not have done. And do you know, Thiruvallar went on to say the young man, I can weave another fabric like this, but our life is also like this fabric. If you tear it apart with hasty, thoughtless actions, it will be destroyed and you will not get it back again. Thiruvallar's words opened the young man's eyes. There and then he decided to give up his idleness and bad habits. See how calmly and patiently Thiruvallar said that I can woo a new fabric once again, but our life is also like a fabric. So Thiruvallar is comparing the life with the fabric that once it has been torn apart, you cannot get it back. Once the life is destroyed, no one can get it back. And the young man realized his mistake and he was very thankful for opening his eyes. I hope, children, you all have understood the chapter and the moral of this chapter very well, that when you are in the state of angriness or when you are very angry, what happens, and when you are very calm and patient, and how our life should be. If in our life we do not pay heed or do not give importance to the hard work, then what will happen? Our life will also become like rags. That means it will become useless. So in our life, always be hardworking, honest, and don't waste your time. I hope you all have liked my educational video. If you liked my video, then kindly like, share, and subscribe. And thank you, children, for watching. God bless you all. Thank you once again.